When Rogue One came out in December 2016, it was divided like no tomorrow. People didn't hate it, they just didn't like it, and saw it as just another unwanted, unnecessary Star Wars film. And others who loved it, oh boy, they adored it. There were those people that walked out of the theater saying, oh my god, that was such an amazing movie. When I walked out of the movie theater, all those people that came out, I heard all of them say, oh, that was awesome. Oh my god, that was cool. In fact, when I left the theater, there was a lineup of people. I shouldn't say I. When me and all those people came out of the theater, there was a lineup of people ready to see the next installment of Rogue One. Not the next installment, the next showing of Rogue One in the theater. And they were telling us to be quiet, and I was going, shh, okay. I didn't even say that, I didn't even tell them if I liked it or not. I just said, okay, all right, enjoy the movie, enjoy the movie. And I just walked into the car and I called my brother and sister and I said, I liked it. And of course, then I called my uncle and told him I liked it. And he says, oh, that's good. And that was it. You know, 2016 was a tough year for a lot of people. My family, of course, because that fall, we lost my paternal grandfather to cancer. And that was a huge loss for all of us. To have this movie come out at the right time for a lot of people, I think that's probably why a lot of people liked it, because it helped them get through the challenges of 2016. For me, I liked it because of the action-packed ending. Well, I mean, yeah, it's a boring build for some, but once you see that action-packed ending, you're gonna want to watch it over and over again, and I think if you actually, you know, eventually you will come to like it. I'm not forcing you to like it. I'm just saying, who knows? You might like it and you might not. You might hate it the first time, but once you see the ending, you might change your mind about it. And that is why a lot of people say it was a movie rescued by the ending, because of how realistic the final battle was shot, the style of battles that they had there. Again, like I said, it was something out of Saving Private Ryan and Hacksaw Ridge. The reason why I liked it was because of what other critics have said. It almost makes you feel like you're in that environment. It almost makes you almost feel like you're in the movie because of how the cinematography shoots it. I don't know what technique it's called. I mean, not even Stanley Kubrick could do such a thing. Maybe he could if he were alive today, but wow. To me, it was a great escape. Is it a movie that I would watch over and over again? It is, actually. Do I like it completely? No, I'm not a super fan of Rogue One. I am a super fan of Star Wars, but this one I'm a fan of, but not a mega fan. Not as much as Empire Strikes Back and Episode 3, Revenge of the Sith. Sorry. I'm out of breath because this was an exciting review. This is a review that I love doing. I'm going to put it like this. It was a great build. It was a great suspense build. I know a lot of people will say the other way around. I personally liked Rogue One because it came out at the right time for everybody. It was a tough year, like I said, so why not watch this one to get you out of that tough time in your life? So I'm going to rate Rogue One, A Star Wars Story, 7 out of 10 film cameras. Because, yes, I agree with what most critics on YouTube have said. It is a bit of a boring build, but the climax was awesome. If you want to see what I'm talking about, check it out. Rent it for yourself off of iTunes or your local library, and enjoy Rogue One, A Star Wars Story.